some of those bizarre, outlandish things you've ever heard in your life. And just as an appetizer and a precursor, what I'm saying to you now, what I shall be saying to you, is there's no proof for it. What I'm saying to you now, what I shall be saying to you, is there's no proof for it. And you don't need any proof. You know, everybody looks in the Bible for validation, for truth that the Bible says, you see. And the truth of the matter is, all the Bible is a validation of what you already know for yourself. And there is no truth that's new to you, that you never heard before, that you never knew before, that's worth learning. I say that everything that I'm going to say to you on this program is what you already know, but you forgot. Somehow you forgot it to become who you are, big fat ego. And you have to forget the truth to become an egotistical person, to become like a god yourself, you know what I mean? Otherwise, if you knew any other god other than yourself, which is contained in the truth that you've forgotten, you couldn't stand yourself. We're always in a state of forgetfulness. We're always trying to forget who we were to validate what we are with lies. And hence, this is the downfall of the human race. We live on a steady diet of lies. And this is the death of the human being. And that's what I'm going to be talking about tonight. Now, you forgive me. I'm fat and old. And there's no question about it, but I'm not going to make excuse, but I've never been inside a hospital until 3 years ago when I had an amoeba. The doctors didn't know what it was. They couldn't figure it out with all their scientific knowledge. I had to figure it out for myself and tell the doctor what medicine to give me, and I was all right. But I think I almost died from it, and my face had turned ashen and gray, and my wrinkles under my eyes and dark spots. And it was just something I picked up swimming in sewage. You know, they let some raw sewage. They never cooked it, and so therefore I swam through it. And what they do to it. But the point is that I aged 10 years in 3 years, and I'm just recovering from it. I mean, my whole stomach swole up, and I, you know, damage to my internal organs. And with all the knowledge they have, they couldn't figure it out. I had to figure it out myself. A doctor friend of mine gave me a medical book, so I understood my insides. And when I did, I used my common sense and discovered what it was. But that helped me, to understand myself. The fact that I had to go without food and couldn't eat made my mind a lot clearer, believe it or not, because food is hypnotic. And food is a killer when it's used to help you forget who you were, to remember who you are. You know, to think more highly of yourself, it's called a high, right? But stress ages. Illness ages. It's the way you react to stress that ages you. And, of course, no one's ever shown the relationship to aging in relationship to reacting to stress. But, you know, I'm going to show you that neurosis, which all of you suffer from, is a disease. And it leads not only to mental conditions, which are illnesses, mental illnesses, which is worth as the precursor to physical illnesses, but physical illnesses too take their toll. Ideally speaking, you should live free without colds, without... You should never see the inside of a hospital, should need a doctor at all, if you live correctly. And theoretically, you should live forever. Human beings are unique. You know, we have records in the Bible of men living 900 years, Methuselah. And slowly as civilization progressed, it wasn't civilization that progressed, it was culture that progressed. Civilization as we know it, or culture, rises as civilization falls. Adam was a civilized man. He knew the truth. He stood close to the source of his existence, his life. Man is created to be an imperishable being, a timeless being in time. And we fall away from this timelessness this truth, this origin of self, and we fall away from the inner environment, the inner sustaining light, which is like the light of the sun to the plant, so does it light up our interior. And we fall away, and we inherit the life of the animal, reacting to stress, responding to our environment, which sustains then